Hello and welcome to this video, where I'll be taking you through the installation steps and overall compatibility of the Whitestone Dome Glass Screen Protector for the Samsung Galaxy Note 10. Though quite pricey, Whitestone have built up a reputation as one of the premium screen protectors on the market. Using their special UV adhesive method, there's a high chance of getting zero imperfections every time you apply, providing you with full coverage, clarity and responsiveness. Starting with the installation, it's best to lay everything out on the table to get to grips with everything you'll need, as there are quite a few steps compared to the regular two-step application. The most important thing is making sure your work surface is flat, as the adhesive can run off the edges if there's even the slightest incline. Before you start the process, make sure you remove any other screen protectors that may already be present, especially if your Note 10 is fresh out of the box, as it comes with a protector attached as standard. First off, give your screen a good clean while lying flat, taking care to get every corner of the screen. Wipe away any excess with the microfiber cloth provided to make sure the screen is completely dry. Go ahead and use the dust removal stickers to check you've not missed anything, as dust can settle on the screen between these steps without you noticing. Now you're ready to insert the Note 10 into the installation tray like so. The tray has speaker written on the top right corner to help you place the phone the right way up. The kit comes with two speaker covers. Remove one and affix it to your speaker to stop the adhesive seeping into the mechanism. Once this is done, take the top section of the tray and place it over the top of the phone, taking care to align the corner with the matching text underneath. Use the two absorption pads and place them either side of the phone, so when the adhesive is applied, there's no excess liquid where it shouldn't be. Give the screen one last pass over with the dust removal stickers to ensure nothing has fallen onto the screen between the steps. Take the plastic pin and insert it into the slot at the top of the tray above the speaker. Attach the plastic bridge into the two slots just below the pin. This will hold the adhesive in place during application. You'll find two adhesive bottles in the box. You'll only need to use one, as the other is provided as a backup in case of any errors during installation. As you can see, there's one coloured cap and one smaller black cap on either end of the tube. Unscrew the coloured cap and place the bottle in the hole on the bridge face down. Don't worry about spilling the adhesive, as it will not disperse until you remove the black cap on the other end. Remove the black cap to allow the liquid to spill out onto the screen, leaving it for a few seconds to completely empty onto the surface. Once the liquid is out, remove the black bridge carefully to avoid moving the bubble. It's now time to apply the screen protector. Peel back the protective film, taking care not to touch the exposed surface. Lower the protector onto the tray, with the bottom touching the screen and the top resting on the black tab. Now take the installation guide and firmly press the suction cup to the shiny side, just opposite the locking cutout. You'll notice a faint circle in the centre of the piece. This will be the indicator for the adhesive placement. Carefully place the installation guide onto the glass, locking the bottom cutout into the base. The next few steps need to be timed perfectly and can be quite tricky to get right, so take your time here. Place your finger on the bottom of the tray to tilt the device enough for the adhesive to slide to the middle of the screen. Once it has reached the indicator circle in the middle of the tray, remove your hands from the bottom and pull out the black tab at the top. If you let the adhesive go past the indicators, this could cause disproportionate coverage of the adhesive, and it will not stick down completely. If done correctly, the protector should drop onto the phone's surface and the adhesive will start to spread to the corners of the phone. Before you start the curing process, wait at least a minute to allow the adhesive to spread evenly. Once the adhesive is spread, grip the suction cup and pull the installation guide away. Now take your UV curing light provided and place it over the tray, starting at the top first for 15 seconds and then moving it to the bottom for a further 15 seconds to complete the initial curing process. Now you can remove the phone from the tray, taking time to wipe away excess adhesive from the sides of the phone. To complete the installation, simply lay the device flat on the surface and repeat the curing process exactly as before, but this time keep the UV light on the speaker and connector ends for 60 seconds each to ensure the protector is completely secure. Now you can enjoy your phone with the peace of mind that your screen is fully protected from wear and tear. I can already see the benefits of this glass protector, causing little to no obstruction to the phone's usage. Texting and surfing through apps, I could see no disruption to the regular responsiveness I'd usually get without a protector. Even while watching videos, it still gives complete clarity to the Note 10's brilliant edge-to-edge display and fits neatly around the newly placed hole punch camera. I can see why phone users are a little apprehensive of the steep cost and lengthy installation process of this protector, but using this technique makes it less likely to result in dust imperfections, which is something I always struggle with when applying regular protectors. Seeing the quality of the final result makes you look past the hassle of the application in favour of the crystal clear coverage. The dome glass works impeccably with the S Pen and inbuilt ultrasonic fingerprint sensor. However, I would highly recommend removing your previous fingerprint and re-scanning it to make sure it works perfectly every time. It also works well with all of the cases I've tried, even the official LED and Clearview covers. I hope you've enjoyed this step-by-step installation guide and review of the Whitestone Dome Glass Screen Protector for the Samsung Galaxy Note 10. If you like the look of this screen protector and would like to purchase one for your Note 10, please follow the links in the description below and feel free to leave any comments if you have any questions. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more mobile accessory news.